Hello, this is a demonstration of the MIT App Inventor crowdsourced translation server. Our server can be reached at weblate.appinventor.mit.edu. When you access that website, you will see a dashboard like this one. You can click around quite a bit and take a look at our existing translations without an account. Here I'll take a look at the Dutch translation. As you can see, here's the launch page for one of our Dutch modules. You can click translate even, and you can even type in a suggested translation, but you can't save. So it's a little bit deceptive. It looks like you can do some translation anonymously with no account, but you can't actually save any of that work until you create an account and it's been approved by me, Susan Lane. The first thing that you should do is click register. Then you can enter your email address, create a username, now you will be sent an email to the account that you submitted with, and it will ask you to verify that email address. After you have done so, your account is registered. At that point, you need to contact me, Susan Lane, for verification that you are actually a human being, and I will grant you permission to write. You don't need to have any credentials as a translator. We would like you to verify for yourself that you know something about the language that you're attempting to translate. But all I am verifying is that you are a human being. Now, once you have verified your account, contacted me, and received word that you have been granted write permission, you can come back to weblate.appinventor.mit.edu and log in, and you will see something like this. You can go from here to browse all projects, and you will see the one project, App Inventor. Click App Inventor, and you will see three modules. Now, most of the translation is in Blockly Messages JSON and ODE messages. No project dialog is, as it looks, for just the "you have no projects" dialog. This is an experiment we have to break out our translations into smaller files. So this is very quick. It's only a few strings. Blockly Messages is the blocks editor. ODE Messages is the designer and all of the components. This one is enormous, and I will warn you that. It is quite possible to get a translation released without every single component in MIT App Inventor translated. So feel free to talk on our community forum, contact me, and we can work through exactly how much of this is necessary for a new translation. It's also a good idea to recruit more than one person to work with you on a translation. This is not a small task. So we'll take a look at the Blockly messages. Here we see a list of all of the languages for which there is currently a translation in some form. You'll see some of these, Hindi has just begun at the time of this recording, whereas Hungarian, Italian, these are released and in maintenance mode. They need to be updated when things in Blockly Editor change. We can choose any of these. We'll start with French. 335 translated strings and 700 total strings. Here we can see, here we have undo, which is not translated in French. And you can look at a machine translation, which suggests annuler as a translation for undo. I'm not going to make any changes. You could make that suggestion and save it. There is a suggest button here, but we are currently not validating suggestions. We don't have the manpower or the language knowledge to go and verify suggestions. Any translation you add here If it is not changed by another translator, will end up in App Inventor production at some time. We can then move through all of the translations for which there are no strings. And that should cover about all you need to know to translate for us in Weblate. You can always reach us at our community forum, community.appinventor.mit.edu, or you can write me personally at srlane@mit.edu, and we'll be happy to answer your questions. Thanks so much for looking to translate for us. Thank you.